So what's going on, guys? Thank you so much for tuning to Skate Informant. I miss you guys. Hope you guys miss me as well. So in the last few months, people have approached me both in YouTube and Instagram asking questions such as, hey, Skate Informant, if I would want to send Terry Kennedy some money or some mail or just anything to support him, do you know how I can reach him? And the question here is, Skate Informant, would you support people that are in favor of Terry Kennedy? And my answer to that would be, well, there is no sides. There is in favor of or against. It's simply a neutral position that we take here at the Skate Informant channel. So if you need information about the situation, I can provide it. If you are, you know, wanting to know about the prosecution, I can provide that information. But we will not take sides because, like I said, I think there's a big problem right now in the world slash this country where it's definitely like either this or that. You know, you can't be in both. You can't be in the middle. Well, we take pride here in being dead in the center. So for anyone that is interested in sending Terry Kennedy mail or anything like that, we have that information. So in your screens, you will see this is DuPageSheriff.org. Once again, DuPageSheriff.org, and this is where you will search for inmates. Obviously, he's in DuPage County. Go to DuPageSheriff.org. Obviously, search for last names. And actually, Terry Kennedy is the only Kennedy that is in there right now. If you do that successfully, you will come across, you know, his mugshot, his, you know, I guess very basic identifying information. Also, the bond. Now, let's take a pause here because initially, when he was first booked and when this news were like headers in a lot of websites, the understanding or the message then was he's been held at $1 million bond. And then I had a video where I was like, oof, that sounds a little excessive. You know, is it because of the celebrity status that he has? Why is it so high? Then people were countering, saying, actually, Skate Informant, it's kind of like not so uncommon for the bond to be set at $1 million. But now that we are officially on the DuPageSheriff.org website, I'm seeing every single case that is open that involves him. Yes, I see the $100,000. That's here. And then a few smaller ones of $10,000 apiece for the other charges. Now, what charges are we talking about? Well, they are all here. Just connect the case number to the dollar amount, and that's what's being charged, right? We have a threatened public official because he said we kill people from where I'm from. You know, it was all over the place. So a few things were mentioned that just added on to the situation. Guys, a reminder, if you are ever in a legal situation, you know your rights when they say everything you say can be used against you. This is a prime example of that. Do not run your mouth, because people will take that and literally turn around and use it to put you even further down. He was already facing a murder charge, right? That somebody lost their lives. Cops show up. You say you're going to hurt them. Bam, just add it on. So, yeah, that's pretty crazy and quite literally used against you, just like your rights indicate. So, but back to this, it doesn't appear that he's been held at $1 million bond. Lisa, or any attorney that's perhaps aware of the situation, correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm seeing he currently resides in Illinois in DuPage, and this is from their website. Why don't we see the $1 million amount? Is it found elsewhere? I don't know if something changed there, but as of now, I'm gonna say it's actually $120,000 for this man to walk free until trial. Now, based on the last court hearing, we may face trial pretty soon. So if I had $120,000 in my pocket, would I throw it into, you know, the courtroom just to walk free for a couple of weeks and then face trial? I don't know, right? It's not me to make that decision. Of course, that's not my situation, but it's definitely a tough question to answer. To me, it's a lot of money, right? I think for the average person, $120K is a lot of money. Anyways, here's a quick summary of his charges, and here's the main question of tonight: mail regulation. So Long story short, can you send mail to Terry Kennedy? Yes, you can. You can send him, I guess, supportive mail, just any kind of mail in the most traditional form, which is obviously paper and written. He is not in JPay. Some people, prefer the electronic method. I was unable to find him in JPay. I don't even think DuPage is registered in JPay. So a few of you guys may remember the Corey Kennedy, another Kennedy that was locked behind bars, locked up. He was, because he was in Washington, and his particular jail did have JPay set up. So we were able to talk to Corey Kennedy. We sent him letters here at Skate Informer, right? We sent him money. I sent him, a few letters here and there electronically through JPay. That is not an option. Now, is it not an option because he is not sentenced yet, doing his actual time just yet, or because the actual jail isn't registered? Well, it's a little bit of both, because yes, I did not find DuPage in JPay, but it doesn't mean that he's gonna end up in DuPage forever to serve his time. He may be transferred somewhere else. So it's still up in the air as far as, will we be able to communicate to TK via JPay electronically in the future? Perhaps. I'll keep you guys informed. But let's actually focus on one disclaimer here, something very important in regards to what you can send him. So here towards the bottom, well, here's his address, of course. His inmate number is 264-941. As of now, his number is 264-941. Can that change in the future? It can, if he gets transferred to another facility. Or this number could very well just follow him everywhere while he's in the system. But let's not put this in stone just yet. But as of now, while he's in Illinois, in Wheaton, this is his address. If you want to send him letters, in written form, you can do that as well. Here's a disclaimer. Here's a warning sign for anyone that wants to send him money. Any cash, coins, phone cards, credit cards, or checks, even in written form, but if it's a check, that will be found in the mail, will be returned to the sender. Guys, don't waste your time trying to send him goods and that of that nature. It will be bounced back. Any mail addressed to an inmate who has been transferred or released will be returned to the sender. So even if you don't send him any kind of money or goods like that, and it comes back, it's likely because he was transferred out to another facility. As of now, he's been in the same place as far as I know, but just be mindful that this address isn't his permanent / serving time address, because trial hasn't even happened yet. So we don't know what he's actually getting. We have speculations, but we don't know what he's actually getting. We're not there yet. And of course, like I said, this is his address. Now, if you are in Illinois and would like to visit him in person, you can do that. You can see Terry Kennedy in person now. Now, what are the visitation, I guess, limits, scheduling, the do's and don'ts? It's all here. Primarily, this is a scheduling for inmate hours or for visitation hours, Wednesdays and Sundays. There's different things for females and males, which is pretty discriminatory if you ask me, but no, there's a reason for all that. So Wednesdays and Sundays for male inmates, and these are the times. And of course, what you need to access, I think this is pretty standard, right? You're going into a correctional facility. You need to fully identify yourself being in there. But I guess the biggest takeaway of this is, can you send Terry Kennedy items? Yes, you can. Can you send him money? No, you can't. It will be bounced back to you. How do I reach him? This is his address. It's basically the jail, but you address it to him as an inmate, and this is his inmate number, 264-941. We cannot send Terry mail electronically right now. It has to be in written form. Guys, that is it. I don't want to make this video any longer than what it needs to. Thank you so much for watching the video. Like always, I'm the Skate Informant. You've been informed. My job here is done, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace.